It's 4 a.m. in Kyiv. Vladimir Putin is threatening more strikes after targeting cities and civilian infrastructure across Ukraine with some of the worst missile strikes since the beginning of the war. President Biden today condemned the attack, promised additional security assistance, including, in his words, advanced air defense systems. In a moment, we'll talk with two retired Army generals about the significance of today. First, CNN's Nick Paton Walsh.
This was the day the war came back to all of Ukraine. The capital, Kyiv, like many cities for months edging towards normal, hit by multiple missile strikes. Carnage at rush hour, central streets hit. The target, unclear. The aim, utter horror. Over 100 missiles and drones. The civilian death toll rising, along with global fury that there was nothing the Kremlin would not hit. Even this Kyiv walkway, to save face from endless losses and the weekend blast that hit another bridge between Russia and Crimea. For a few hours this morning, almost all of Ukraine's cities seemed under attack. The bus next to this crater caught by one of two missiles, critically injuring five.
Well, you can see the utter ferocity of the explosion here by the hole one of the two rockets made. But it's also a curious question as to why this was indeed the target. It seems like this telecoms facility was unused at the time it was struck, but also too, the callous disregard for human life being shown. All these apartment blocks just within the blast radius.
This woman said she ran her two children back into the kitchen in the minutes between the two missiles. Homes here gone and winter ahead, made worse by the power cuts the missiles caused, however fast the recovery is.
It is terrible. It is a crime against civilians.
Anger here, some fear, but also resilience, echoed by Ukraine's president. There may be temporary blackouts, he said, but our confidence, the confidence in our victory, will never have a blackout. Why these particular strikes? The enemy wants us to get scared, wants us to run. We can only run forward and demonstrate that at the battlefield. Russia's brutality was always a known quantity, but Ukraine's stubborn resistance still surprises. This day, sharing a video of a soldier shooting down a missile with a shoulder-launched rocket.
Ваня, давай!
A David who wants more advanced arms to defend itself from a weakened Goliath. Yeah! A call that this rare and chilling moment of terror across the country will only amplify.
Nick, is it clear if Vladimir Putin thinks this retaliation has been some sort of success? Is it expected to be repeated?
I think certainly for the domestic audience, which I think it's most likely intended for, there has been an element of success. Certainly key critics have said they're now happy with the conduct of the war, and there had been calls among the Russian elite after the extraordinary failures of the past weeks or even months that they changed tactics or were, quote, tougher. Is this something that Russia can repeat on a regular basis? Well, you have to ask yourself, given there's not been some sudden change in how merciful Russia's wanted to be towards civilians, they have hit civilians since the beginning of the war, whether or not this would have been done in the past more regularly. It may be down to limits in Russia's own arsenal. We don't know how many cruise missiles they have, but you probably imagine they don't have 80 plus to use every single day. So this has certainly been a use of a limited amount of arsenal to try and send a message. Yes, to Ukraine, that probably hasn't worked, but it probably has had more of an impact on Russia's own elite, dampening that criticism and showing that the Russian leader Vladimir Putin still has a card to play in this war. It's done some damage to critical infrastructure here. It's taken some civilian lives. I think certainly for a few hours this morning, many Ukrainians were shaken because cities that had been essentially getting back to some degree of normality away from the fronts in the south and east were suddenly being hit intensely. Do we think we'll see this again in the weeks ahead? It's possible. I think, though, Russia's struggling with all of its inventories here, shells, cruise missiles, basic diesel fuel for tanks, soldiers. They're all a struggle right now. This, I think, has been a show of brutal force, but I'm not sure it's something they're able to pull off on a nightly basis, Anderson.
Nick Paton Walsh, appreciate it. Thank you. Be careful. So with Russia now reduced to targeting cities and people in them. What does that say about the state of the war for what Nick Paton Walsh just called a weakened Goliath? Joining us, CNN military analyst, retired Army Lieutenant General Mark Hertling, also retired Army Brigadier General Peter Zwack. He served as defense attaché to Russia during the Russian invasion of Ukraine and annexation of Crimea in 2014. General Hertling, even a weakened Goliath can cause a lot of chaos and destruction. Do you have any idea how long Russia could continue to carry out attacks on today's scale?
I think we have to point out, Anderson, that this is not a change in tactics by Russia. They've been doing these kinds of things since the very beginning. In terms of answering your question, how long can they do it? They obviously attempted to do a equivalent of a shock and awe day yesterday. And even with the 84, by Ukrainians count, 84 missiles, 24 drones, half of both numbers were shot down by Ukrainian forces as they flew overhead. So yes, there was a lot of damage done to civilian infrastructure, but again, Mr. Putin is a one-trick pony. He has been attacking civilian infrastructure with rockets and missiles since the beginning of this campaign. None of that has contributed to him achieving any of his political or military end state goals. So, you know, I gotta believe that sanctions are hurting him, that his weapon systems are faltering. There's, remember, way back long ago, we were finding out that about 60% of Russians' missiles were failing during launch. So a combination of fewer with more failures, with the same strikes against civilian targets, which are criminal, I don't know. I don't believe he can keep this up much longer.
General Zwack, what does it say if Nick is right and this attack, these strikes, were largely for a domestic Russian audience? What does that say about what lies ahead?
These attacks, as General Hertling had mentioned, is really a follow-on of behaviors going all the way back to the first evening of 24 February. They're amping it up. I feel frustration in these strikes. The Russians have not been able to beat the plucky, nimble and capable Ukrainian military in the field. So the Kerch Bridge was dropped several days ago. And I just think that this is sort of a manifestation of frustration, rage, power. And I think it's all it's going to do. It's going to harden the Ukrainians even more that went through incredibly anxious days in February and March. And this just continues the negative narrative. He may get some points for being strong and tough, but this isn't long-term going to play well in Russia. And also, it really enhances, continues this sort of black hat aspect of the Russians in the international community in the United Nations.
And General Hertling, just in terms of the months ahead, what does the war continue to look like?
Well, we're going to see some changes in the environment, certainly, Anderson, but that affects both sides, and I'm talking about weather. Ukraine continues to generate momentum. There's an attempt by Russia to incorporate mobilized soldiers, which we've seen through internal Russian reports. There are more people running out of country than there are moving and marching to mobilization stations. And even if they get some of those Russian soldiers to the front line, they're going to be joining units that are actually depleted, low morale, and have not achieved any success on the battlefield. So we're going to see an increased momentum by the Ukrainian forces. You're going to see more defeats on the battlefield by the Russian forces. And unfortunately, we're probably going to see more, since we have since the 24th of February, as Peter said, more artillery and missile strikes against civilian targets and more criminal activities that puts Russia and Mr. Putin in an aspect that they should be brought before the Hague.